on the outside, also on the inside of the board to give people a lot more fun. So the length of the board is 168 centimeters, which is very short for a battery operated board. You've got the rope handle with the remote control. Here is a battery hatch. So simply how to use this product is the battery must go in here. Okay, so how to put it in? Here we have a cap, which is a vacuum system inside the board. We take off the cap, which releases the air in here. We push the battery down into position, and then we simply put the cap back on here. It'll vacuum lock the battery into the cap. The battery will not be able to come out. Simply take the battery out, we release the cap again and pull the battery out. So once that's done and you're ready, you're in the water, you want to start. This will be on your wrist. This is a key magnet, remote control. We put this into the hole at the back of the remote control, and when we want to take off, simply pull the trigger and we go. When you want to stop or you fall off the board, the magnet will fall out of the remote and the board will stop. There's no other magnet strapped to your leg that you can knock off sometimes, which is a bit of a nuisance. For the product to use, simple, put a battery in, and off you go. It's a very, very simple, beautiful looking product. It's small, it's powerful, it's got great turning and it's a lot of fun. We take a look at the underside of the board here. This is where a lot of the changes have been taking place. We've added here the hard rails on the edge here. It helps with turning. These rails will add speed through the turn and gives you better performance. It's working so much better. Now, also the intake of the jet, we've made it a little bit longer so we don't get the air bubbles going in, the water flows in a lot faster. During your hard turns, it keeps the speed up as well. The impeller's been improved as well, so all this section of the board has been changed around and it's a much better performance at the moment. Very simple fin system. We have the case here for the fins. You just slide them into place. As you're riding in this direction, the water is pushing in this direction, so the fins will not be able to come out. Simply to get them out, you push them off again. That's a basic closer look at the second model of the Ripsnorter. It is a beautiful looking board. I hope you enjoy it. The other improvements also I could mention is the battery pack. Around the battery cells. We're also using now a smart BMS system which has a full balancing system that you can see on your phone or your app, which gives you an alarm if there's any problem with the battery. When you're charging the battery, you can see cell balancing and see which cells are unbalanced, and during the charge, you can actually watch it all balance up into place. It's a lot better system. The ECU has also been upgraded to latest MOSFETs and capacitors. So everything here is looking very good. Hope you enjoy.